Hello. My name is Stacey Gonzalez. I wrote down most of my speech because obviously I didn't know what was really expected. So I figured I would just share my experience with you. 2 years ago was the happiest time of my life. I found that I was going to have a little girl. I was going to have a little mini me. I have two older boys, which are 11 and 6. Around 28 weeks of my pregnancy, I had noticed a lot of differences from my first two pregnancies, but I never in a million years thought I was having heart complications. I noticed I had extreme fatigue. I was always tired. I barely had any energy to do simple tasks, such as wash dishes, clean up around the house. I had no energy to do anything. I was short of breath by walking very short distances, literally from my car to my house. I swelled very badly in my feet and my legs to the point I couldn't really wear shoes. I wore slide-on sandals. Overall, I just did not feel well. My prior two pregnancies were very pleasant. I never experienced any morning sickness alone, let alone swollen feet. They were very easy pregnancies. This was also new to me. I complained to my OBGYN on several occasions and pretty much was told to take it easy. This is my third pregnancy and that these feelings were normal, especially while trying to keep up with two other children and maintain a household and work. Slow down and put your feet up as much as possible is what I was told, pretty much. I guess there was no real reason for concern. Overall, I was 29 years old with two prior healthy full-term babies, and so I just went through my pregnancy thinking every pregnancy is different, and in the end, everything will be worth it. On April 20th, 2018, I went to the hospital. C-section. My two previous babies were breached, so I was doing my third C-section, and I was finally going to meet the love of my life. While preparing for my C-sections, they had a few problems, nothing serious, just giving me the IV, and then there were some issues with the epidural. And I was stuck two times, but overall everything went smooth. Within the next few hours, my little girl was born and everything here seemed like the perfect fairy tale. Over the next few days, I began to become more and more swollen. The nurses checked my ankles for pitting several times, but never showed any real concern. 3 days later, I was being released from the hospital. I was so excited. I was so excited to bring my new baby home. I was discharged from the hospital on April 23rd at 3:45 in the afternoon. And that night, I kept feeling very short of breath, like walking to and from the bathroom, but again, maybe the third C-section made this possible, and I'm overdoing it. Plus, I suffered from anxiety, and I was no longer taking medication since I'd become pregnant. So I kept telling myself, I'm just having good anxiety. As it got later and later into the night, I realized it was getting harder and harder to breathe, even on the recliner. And eventually I noticed I could feel the fluid building up in my chest when I would call, just breathe. And yeah. At this point it was 3 a.m. in the morning and I called my OB and they instructed me to go to the emergency room. This is where my fairy tale turned into a nightmare. My life literally flashed in front of me. Immediately when I arrived at the hospital where I delivered my daughter, they ran a series of tests and started me on oxygen because my levels were really low, and eventually they put me on a BiPAP machine. This is when I realized things were not okay, and this was not just a really bad panic attack. I will never forget laying down waiting for the nurses to do my MRI, staring at the ceiling, crying. I could not breathe. It was the worst feeling. I was laying there alone and scared to death, literally. Once I was admitted, I was told I was having heart failure and I had pneumonia and I should contact my family. I lost it. Immediately called my cousin and one of my good friends and ask them to please support my husband. My husband was home getting my kids ready for school that morning. And I was basically laying there dying, laying my new cradle on my head. When I texted him and told him everything was okay and I was fine, I don't like people to worry, and he knew I wasn't okay. The next few days were such a blur. I was in ICU fighting to get better. I saw so many doctors, more than I can count. Nobody really had a straight answer at first. Then I met a wonderful cardiologist. I'll never forget her face. She came into the room and promised me I would make it home to see my children. She kept their promise. The first few days were terrible. I couldn't eat, I couldn't sleep. I heard a machine beep, I thought I was dying. I didn't sleep for 48 hours. I was petrified, I wouldn't wake up. I didn't want to have company, I didn't want anyone to be sad around me. I just wanted my baby, but I also didn't want to see her either. I still didn't believe that I was going to be okay. I really believe after everything I've been through, that's where a lot of my depression is coming from. I never wanted something so badly. I had to quit breastfeeding. I never breastfed my other two children. And this one, I was actually successful. It didn't last long, obviously. But, I mean, it breaks my heart every day that I wasn't able to continue. Moving forward into my recovery, I found my cardiologist who was recommended by Dr. James Fett. I'm not sure if anybody's heard of him, but he's done many studies. Is he familiar? Yeah, I guess. He is. He's amazing. I found him. I don't know why I go on Facebook and I'm Googling, but I found a support group on Facebook and I met Dr. James Fett, and he's literally has been there for the last year just to answer any questions. Is this normal? Is that normal? Rather than calling Megan Clark. He's amazing. But I talked to James Fett. I found him in a support group. He's done many studies, as you know, and he's been a huge help. He recommended I travel to UPenn and see Dr. Paul Mather and his team, so I did. Since then, I had my medications adjusted. I followed the low sodium diet for a while, and I completed cardiac rehab, which really helped tremendously and overall how I feel now. I do not think I will ever be completely back to normal, but I definitely feel 95% better than I did 1 year ago coming home from the hospital. I have many days that I cry because I'm still facing my own emotional trauma, but I'm thankful to be here and see my kids grow up. There's many days that I have to stay indoors while my kids are outside playing or at the beach because it's just too humid and it makes it really hard to breathe. I feel it's almost like I'm suffocating. I just can't get that good fresh breath of air. Since my heart failure, I have not slept flat. I always need at least two pillows underneath of me, and now I sleep on my side just to prevent myself from having the panic attacks and feeling like I did on the night of the 24th. There is much heightened anxiety after my diagnosis. Every chest pain, every heart palpitation, shortness of breath during menstruation, every cold I get, like I am now. Every time my heart races, I worry. I can say I'm definitely more aware of my heart now and every beat of it. My EFN diagnosis was 40%, and I'm currently at 55%. When I found out that my EF had increased, I thought this was great news, which it is. Definitely. But I thought my doctor would want to start taking me off of the medications. Well, that was false. My cardiologist would like me to stay on medications for life due to the possibility of relapsing and being in a more worse situation the next time around. I was pretty upset for a while from hearing this news because I thought once I was recovered and I would be off medications. But I put my heart into my doctor's hands, and I trust that he's making the best decisions for me. I want to live a long life, and I trust that I will. Moving forward into my life now, I would just like to say that I wish I have heard about sooner than being in a hospital bed, being told that this is a very rare form of heart failure, and I'm one in 3,000 pregnancies that this occurs in. And I'm lucky to have listened to my body. God has a plan for me, and I know this was not a part of it. I'm thankful for all the great care I received and continue to receive. I'm thankful to be here and share my story. Moms are dying. It's 2019. Women need awareness. We need to pay attention to the signs of something that could potentially kill you. No mom deserves to die. Thank you for listening.